Sister Amelita, Sister Ronaline Gilado, Rinald Anciano, Bernadette Rosario, Sister Nomi Tobio, Ma'am Bing Agbunes, Sister D. Agbunes, regards to Pastor Celso. Praise God. Sister Marilyn Buhia, I think the Buhia family is now enjoying their camp. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And while you are watching there, Dr. Sharon, God bless. Thank you for watching. Alandel Busa Idea, Brother Radmar, where are you now? Praise God. Sister Loida, watching at Titan Park View. Yes, good afternoon, Sister Nomi, Pastor Pirico, praise God, and Sister Lumiaris, Mariang, Sister Rose Sullivan, Marie Python is watching. Sister Marie, sabi mo, hindi ka makapanood. Praise God. Thank you. Praise God for watching. Brother Redemption Cabildo, God bless. Long time no see na, Brad. Sister Minda Calderon is watching. So while you are watching, don't forget to share it. Don't forget to share. Praise God, so that we can reach a lot of people. This lesson is very important, praise God. Especially to those people who think that their own good works will merit or will gain salvation. But we remember our part one yesterday. Praise God that our righteousness is just filthy rags. No one is doing good. And Christ, praise God, have paid everything on the cross of Calvary that we might have eternal life. So now that we are saved, by the grace of Christ, we must do good works and let us maintain good works. Praise God, that's what the Bible said. But we will continue this afternoon of our lesson. Hallelujah. And thank you, Together Church, Pastor Mahadukon, of your nice album. Yan po ang ating background song. God bless Sister Nida, regards to Tio Dodo. Brother June, Sister Taberna, Jungjung Kirante, may hapon. Brother Jung, Sonia Iruda, praise God. East Diam is watching. Gail Enriquez is watching. Ashley Jean Pajardo is watching. Pastor Joseph Galos, ang ating kaisa-isang membro ata ito na KBP sa Mindanao. Praise God. Hallelujah. Kining ato ani sir, ano, inato rani inato. Ruina Lajuna. Yes, Sister Mariang watching from Tagum. Regards diyan sa pamilya Lumiares. May Salvador. Prayer request. Pwede request ng kanta. Praise God. Kabulong kantaan. Praise God. Alan Busa Idea, Ricardo Ustunal, Lese De Vera is watching with us. Praise God. Request ko kanta, sir. Sige. Isa may request na to, Pastor Joseph. Kanang itugyan ang tanan niya. Mundot na ina kanta. Francisco Rabang and Salvi Luna is watching. Silda Jurado is watching. Praise God. From La Carlota City, Negros Oriental, on that blue corner, Sister Wing Abadias. Thank you, Sister Wing. Praise God. May the Lord bless you. From Imus, Cavite, Sister Sonia Eroda. Richard Chard is watching with you. Brother Richard, how are you? May the Lord bless you. Praise God. So, in few minutes, we will start our lesson in part 2. Muslim Piskisa is watching from Wapom. Siongsoy. Hirap naman i-pronounce ang Mr. Rosley. Ito po ay border na po. Malapit sa border ng China. Praise God. Ako walang COVID po doon. Hallelujah. Arlen Pasio. Regards. Sister Ping sa'yo. Sister Cecil. Sister Merna from Greece. Tayo na natin naabot, mga kapatid. From Greece. Juna Ignacio. Doctolero. Si Naida Doctolero. Binuan Rapanan. He's watching this. Watching also with us. Hallelujah. Yes, yes, Sister Wing. Nasa mabuting kalagayan po kami. Purihin ang Diyos. Rinaline Martin Barros. God bless you, sis. Good afternoon. So, mamaya, balikan natin, mga kapatid, ang ating mga greetings. Praise God. Tayo po tutuloy sa ating mga lessons. Sa mga oras na ito, let us come to prayer. Praise God. Rodolfo Kita, Kitua, Ronaline Ginitan, Darlene Iscaros is watching with us. May the Lord will bless you. And let us come into prayer. Let us finish this lesson. Praise God. Heavenly Father, we come to you, Lord, with a humble heart. Cleanse our mind. Thank you for this day that you have given us strength. Holy One of Israel, I need your anointing. Bless the listeners even in this afternoon. Thank you so much, Lord. And I declare salvation, Lord, to those who have who open their heart. Lead them, O God, as the Spirit will guide them unto the way of salvation. Thank you so much, Lord. Bless the ministers of the gospel who preaches the apostolic message, and this we ask in your mighty name, Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen and amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, sa mga oras na ito, mga kapatid, atin pong ituloy, praise God, ang ating mga lessons. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Kung meron po kayong banal na kasulatan, if you have a Bible or you can just follow on our screen, praise God. In Acts chapter 10, verse 1 to 5, praise God. This would be our foundation of scripture that we are going to discuss this afternoon. Praise God. Our good works, where is it in the timeline of our salvation? So remember the statement yesterday, and I'm going to say it again. You are not saved by your good works, but you are saved to do good works. Okay? Praise God. So we are saved by grace, not of ourselves, so that no one will boast. And this up and in this continuation, I will show to you, praise God, a story, praise God, concerning the life of Cornelius. So the Bible said, okay, praise the Lord, hallelujah. There was a certain man in Caesarea called Cornelius, a centurion of the band called the Italian band, a devout man. Now, please and kindly look at the description of this guy. A devout man and one that feared God with all his house, which gave much alms to the people and prayed to God always. So, verse 2 is the details and the description how religious, how good is this man named Cornelius. He was a devout man, one that feared God with all his house, which gave much alms to the people. So he gives a lot of charities and he helped a lot of people. And aside from that, he prayed to God always. Then he saw in a vision, evidently, about the ninth hour of the day, an angel of God coming into him and saying unto him, Cornelius. And when he looked on him, he was afraid and said, What is it, Lord? And he said unto him, Thy prayers and thine alms are come up for a memorial before God. And now the angel said, and I believe that the angel speaks to him a Latin or a Greek. Praise God, Greek language, not Hebrew, because Cornelius is a Gentile. So the angel was talking to him in his language, okay? So the angel told him that he need to pick up Peter and now send men to Joppa and call for one Simon whose surname is Peter. And then we will jump to the verse 45. So Peter arrived in their house and he preached the name of Jesus Christ, and they of the circumcision, the Jewish people which believed, were astonished, as many as came to with Peter, because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. So this is the first recorded story in the book of Acts that the Gentile people, praise God, received the gift of the Holy Ghost. In Acts chapter 2, it was all Jewish in the upper room who received the gift of the Holy Ghost. In Acts chapter 8, praise God, in Samaria, mixed, okay, half Jewish, half Gentile, they also received the gift of the Holy Ghost and they were baptized in Jesus' name. But in Acts chapter 10, this is purely Gentile group of people. So when Peter arrived into their house, now remember, this Cornelius is a good man. He has a good works, but he is not saved yet. So if you depend right now on your good works because you help a lot of people, or maybe, Cornelius pray and he feared God, all his household. He is a devoted man and he helps a lot. But the angel told him to call Peter because Peter will preach to him the plan of salvation. In other words, Cornelius is not yet saved. His good works and his prayer, the angel said, it ascended up to heaven and becomes a memorial before God. Okay? Praise God. So when Peter was preaching in his house, and those Jewish people that went with Peter into the house of Cornelius, they were astonished, na-shocked po sila eh. Sa dahilan na akala nila, praise God, na ang gift of the Holy Ghost is only exclusively for the Jewish people. Okay? But to their amazement, praise God, they saw the event in the house of Cornelius and they said, praise God, as many as came with Peter, praise God, they were astonished. Why? Because that on the Gentiles also was poured out the gift of the Holy Ghost. Praise God. Paano nila nalalaman? How did they know, praise God, that these Gentiles receive the gift of the Holy Ghost? Okay? They said, for they heard them speak with tongues. Okay? The evidence And the reason why they come up to the conclusion that the people inside the house of Cornelius really received the genuine, the authentic gift of the Holy Ghost that they received also during the day of Pentecost, praise God, because they see somebody is crying? No. Because they saw somebody is rolling on the ground? No. Because they saw somebody is shouting? No. The Bible said, they concluded that they received the Holy Ghost for they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. So there are two criteria here that really they said, this is the Holy Ghost that we received in the day of Pentecost. Praise God. And they said, oh, wow, the Holy Ghost was given also to the Gentiles. It's being poured out to the Gentiles. Praise God. Why? Because they heard them speak with tongues and magnify God. So anybody, anyone, as far as my experience is concerned, when someone is filled with the Holy Ghost or being baptized with the Spirit of God, he or she cannot control, praise God, he or she will magnify God for thanksgiving because of this heavenly experience. And I experience it. So the point in this story, in regards to our topic, praise God, where is our good works in the timeline of our salvation? I repeat it again in our part one that our good works would not merit to have eternal life or to have salvation. But our good works is very important after we receive the plan of salvation, after we repented of our sins, after we baptized in the water in Jesus' name and receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. We must maintain that good works for our benefit and for the benefit of other people. I will show you a lot of verses today why we must continue to do good works, praise God, now that we are saved by the grace of God. It doesn't mean that while now that we are saved by this grace, we will not do good works. Praise God. Good works, not for salvation, but good works because we are already saved. Okay, is that clear? As what Reverend Woodward said, you are not saved by your own works, but you are saved by Jesus Christ to do good works. Okay? Praise God. So, back to our text this afternoon. In this very nice story in Acts chapter 10, it is very clear there are some facts here. Number one, that salvation is also extended to the Gentiles. That the Holy Ghost is also given to the Gentiles. Number three, which is the most important, that our good works. Now remember, Cornelius was a devout man. He helped a lot. Okay, he feared God with all his family. And he prayed God always. But the angel told him, all your righteousness, all your personal righteousness, all your good works just ascended to heaven as a memorial before God. And the angel told him, please call Peter. Because Peter will bring you words in or give you instruction what to do. Praise God. And now Peter arrived in his house and here we go. In the middle of his preaching, the Holy Ghost came. Okay? So when they heard him speak with tongues and magnify God, then Peter answered. Then Peter answered. Can anyone forbid water that they should not be baptized, which have received the Holy Ghost as well as we? Now, let us dissect this verse very carefully. When the companions of Peter, okay, heard that the audience in the house of Cornelius did speak in tongues and glorify God, they compared one to another, and Peter said, who can forbid water? Who can stop the water that they should not be baptized? Okay? Those who receive the Holy Ghost as well as we. What Peter was saying that in the day of Pentecost, those 120 disciples, more or less, included Mary, the mother of Jesus, she received also the gift of the Holy Ghost. He said that no one can stop now, no one can forbid them to be baptized. They should be baptized. Okay? No one can stop them now. They should be baptized. Now, the fourth truth in this story is that after they received the gift of the Holy Ghost, when in fact, this is one of the story that they received first the Holy Ghost before the water baptism. So, receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost and water baptism in Jesus' name are two separate events in a personal life or in a person's life or in a believer. Kasi maraming nagsasabi na pag nabaptize ka na daw sa tubig, automatic may Holy Ghost na. Hindi po yan totoo, ha? That's a deception. That's a deception. Praise God. That is why we baptize in the name of Jesus. Kasi ang sabi, oh, I baptize you in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Ghost. Oh, nabautismuhan na daw siya sa Holy Ghost. Wala yan sa Bible, kapatid. Because baptism in the Bible should be done in the name of Jesus. So, now, the sequence of event in Acts chapter 10 is unique because after hearing or while they are hearing the preaching of Peter, the Holy Ghost came to them. And the Jewish people said, wow, it's genuine because we hear them speak in tongues and they glorify God. And Peter answered, can any man forbid water that this should not be baptized, which received the Holy Ghost as well as we? So those experiences that they have in the day of Pentecost, praise God, was the template. They said, oh, this is real. This is like what we received before. Praise God. So the fourth truth in this story, praise God, is that after you receive the gift of the Holy Ghost, you must be baptized in the water. The question, on what name? Okay, here we go in verse 48. And he commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. Okay? Then prayed he him to tarry certain days. So, they commanded them to be baptized in the name of the Lord. So, what's the name of the Lord? Who's the name of the Lord? Jesus Christ. So, they baptized them in the name of the Lord. Praise God. So, I repeat it again. Our good works before the new birth cannot merit anything. Praise God. But when you experience the new birth experience, being born of water and of the Spirit, praise God, you need now to do good works. Okay? Praise God. Don't be confused with that. So, praise God. The Bible tells us yesterday in our part 1 that our righteousness is just a filthy rags in the presence of God. Praise God. So, Paul also supported that idea or the truth in Romans chapter 10, at chapter 3, verse 10. He said, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. Okay? Without Jesus, without repentance, water baptism, and the gift of the Holy Ghost coming into our life, praise God, our good works would not qualify to the salvation that God will give to every humankind. Praise God. Because the truth is, as it is written, there is none righteous, no, not one. Lahat po, lahat ng tao, mga kapatid. The Bible said in verse 11, there is none that understand it. There is none that seek it after God. Hallelujah. That is why he wrote this verse in 21. But now, the righteousness of God without the law is manifested, being witnessed by the law and the prophets. 22. Even the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ unto all and upon all that believe. For there is no difference. Praise God. There's no more difference between Jew and Gentiles. Oh, there's no more difference. Praise God. Hallelujah. Wala na pong pagkakaiba. There is no man or woman, Jew or Gentile. Praise God. Hallelujah. So be careful of some deceptions and teachings. Praise God that Jewish is separate. Praise God, Gentiles is separate. No. When Christ, praise God, was hung, hallelujah, died on the cross of Calvary, praise God, if you believe, praise God, with all of your heart, what He has done on the cross of Calvary, praise God. The Bible said, that's the righteousness of God. The righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ, unto all. Unto all. Para po sa lahat. Walang religion. Religion yan. Lahat para sa lahat. Sa lahat kanino? Upon all them that believe. So we need to believe what Christ has done on the cross of Calvary. Because our own good works, we cannot pass, praise God, to the measurement of the holiness of God. only the righteousness of God, when we receive the righteousness of God, which is by faith of Jesus Christ. Kanino natin, saan tayo maniniwala? Kay Kristo Jesus, mga kapatid. Unto all and upon all them that believe. For there is no difference. Wala na pong pagkakaiba. Mapastor ka, mamimro ka, praise God, masakristan ka, maworker ka, mapresidente ka, mga kapatid, profesional ka man, walang pinag-aralan, sa mata ng Diyos, pantay-pantay lahat, there is no difference. So what makes the difference now if there is no difference on our position and wealth? If you believe in Christ. So the two categories now is, are you a believer or unbeliever? I choose to believe. I choose to believe. Praise God. Hallelujah. At kinamamanik ko sa inyo. Praise God. Please, kindly, praise God. Ask God, Lord, give me faith in my heart. I want to believe you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Hindi tayo mga atheist, mga kapatid. Tayo po ay mga believers. Praise God sa ating Panginoong Jesus. Hallelujah. Tingnan po natin kung talaga bang hindi tayo nakaabot sa sukatan ng Panginoon. For all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. Lahat talaga nagkasala. Lahat. As in lahat. Mga kapatid. But if you repented of your sins, praise God, and be converted, that's what the Bible said, praise God, in Acts, hallelujah, chapter 3, huh? Praise God, verse 19, that's what the Bible said. Look at on your screen, Acts 3:19. Repent ye therefore, because all of us had committed sin. Lahat tayo nagkasala eh. Praise God. Kung meron man mag-claim na yun na wala kang kasalanan, siguro hindi ka taga-earth. Praise God, taga-ibang planeta ka. Praise God, hindi ka siguro tao, baka robot ka. Dapat every human being committed sin. There is no righteous, no, not one. But, the Bible said, if you repent, pag nagsisisi ka mga kapatid, and be converted, ma-convert ka, praise God, mabago ka, praise God, that your sins may be blotted out when the times of the refreshing shall come from the presence of the Lord. Praise God. So, pag ikay na bautismuhan, praise God, mapapatawad ang iyong kasalanan. Yun naman mga kapatid, ang tanong talaga ng mga tao kay Pedro. Praise God. Hallelujah. Sa verse 37, mga kapatid, ng Acts chapter 2, ito po ang sabi ng mga tao. Now when they heard this, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter. Now remember, the same Peter, there's only one Peter here, in the book of Acts. Praise God. The same Peter who preaches in the house of Cornelius said earlier for the Jewish people in Jerusalem. He said, they were pricked in their heart and said unto Peter and to the rest of the apostle, men and brethren, what shall we do? Praise God. What shall we do? Sabi ng mga tao, ano sagot ni Pedro? Then Peter said unto, repent. Repent talaga. Magsisi talaga dahil nagkasala. Wala pong matuwid, walang mabuti, wala. Wala talaga. Palpak lahat mga kapatid. So if you are depending right now in your good works, you cannot avail salvation. Because our good works would not avail, praise God, salvation. It would not merit. But after we are being baptized, after we are saved by the grace of God, by repentance, water baptism, and receiving the gift of the Holy Ghost, then, the Bible said, we must maintain good works. Yun po, mga kapatid. Okay? Then Peter said unto them, repent, and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins, ye shall receive the gift of the Holy Ghost. So ano ang sikreto para mapatawad ang kasalanan? Magpabautismo sa pangalan ni Jesus sa tubig, at tanggapin ang kaloob ng banal na Espiritu. Maliwanag po, napakaliwanag mga kapatid. Hallelujah. Now, in Hebrews chapter 24, praise God. Ito po mga kapatid ay address na po sa mga baptized in Jesus' name, sa mga nagpapatuloy na po, praise God, sa iglesia. Those who continue to serve the Lord in their local churches, this is what the Bible said. Let us consider one another to provoke unto love and to good works. Okay? Hindi tayo magpasikatan, mga kapatid, sa abilidad, sa mga bahandi, sa Bisaya pa, sa mga kayamanan sa mundong ito. But let us consider one another to provoke unto love. Kung sa Bisaya pa, maghinagitay ta diha sa gugma ug sa maayong mga buhat. Okay? Praise God. Basahin natin sa Tagalog yung verse na yan, mga kapatid. Praise God. Hebrews chapter 10, verse 24. Ito po ang pagkasabi sa Tagalog version. at tayo'y mga tinginan upang tayo'y mga udyok sa pag-iibigan at mabubuting gawa. Praise God. Hallelujah. So, kung mag-contest man tayo, praise God. Hallelujah. Let us have a contest of love and good works. Praise God. Let us provoke. Hagito nato ang usag-usa. So, Bisaya pa, mga kapatid. Hallelujah. 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 12. Ito po, mga kapatid. Look at very carefully. Having your conversation honest among the Gentiles. Okay? Sinulat ito ni Pedro. That whereas they speak against you as evildoers, they may by good works, did you see that? That by good works, which they shall behold, glorify God in the day of visitation. Praise God. Dahil kung makikita ng mga unbeliever na hindi tayo gumagawa ng mabuti, taliwas sa mga salita ng Diyos, mga kapatid, hindi mag-glorify ang Panginoon sa kanyang pagbalik. Praise God. Hallelujah. Within fact, mga kapatid, even the women in the old in the time of the early church who profess godliness, huh? Praise God, they have good works. Kailangan ng mga babae din, mga kapatid. Ano sabi ni Timothy, ni Pablo kay Timothy, but which becometh women professing godliness with good works. With good works talaga, mga kapatid. Now remember this, that we are His workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works. We have mentioned that yesterday, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. We must walk in them, mga kapatid. So, we must maintain that good works, praise God, until the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. So, I repeat it again, praise God, hallelujah, that our good works is very important. Praise God. For salvation, no. We must maintain that because we are already saved. Praise God. Hallelujah. And the Bible said that they will glorify your Father which is in heaven. This is my last verse. Jesus said, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and glorify your Father which is in heaven. So, kailangan maging ilaw tayo sa madilim na sanlibutan, mga kapatid. Praise God. I repeat it again. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works. Nag-light ka lang ng shine, pero kung wala kang good works, ano makikita nila? Praise God. Diba? Kaya, let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and they will glorify your Father which is in heaven. So, that is our episode 2 of the subject, Our Good Works. Where is it in the timeline of our salvation? Praise God. Hallelujah. I repeat it again. Praise God. The story of Cornelius. Cornelius was a devout man. He prayed always. He gave charities, much alms to the nation of Israel. He prayed to God always. But, see, his good works did not qualify for him for salvation, but it becomes a memorial before God, and God wanted him to be saved. That is why an angel appeared to him to call Peter to preach the message of salvation. And when Peter preached in the house of Cornelius, he received the gift of the Holy Spirit, first time in the history of the Gentile people. Praise God. And why did they concluded that what they received is a real authentic gift of the Holy Ghost? Because they heard them speaking with tongues and they glorify God. And Peter said, okay, those who receive the Holy Ghost, they must be baptized in water. Praise God. So Peter commanded them, guided them, gave them instruction that they must be baptized in the name of our Lord. So, praise God, di mo dumakapatid na kapag ikaw ay mabuting tao, praise God, kapag ikaw ay hindi nananakit sa kapwa, hindi po ibig sabihin na ligtas ka na. Praise God. Mabait ka, gumagawa ka na mabuti, tumutulong ka, hindi po ibig sabihin na ligtas na ang iyong kaluluwa. Kailangan mo pa ring mabautismuhan sa tubig at makatanggap ng gift of the Holy Ghost. At pagkatapos niyan, ituloy mo, hallelujah, ang isang ugaling maganda, mabuting gawa. Ituloy mo lang, i-maintain mo yon. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Yan ang sinabi ng banal na kasulatan, mga kapatid. So let us maintain that. good works, so that people will glorify God in heaven. So, dito na lang po tayo, mga kapatid. Praise God. At salamat sa Panginoon. At atin pong dalhin, mga kapatid, ang lahat sa pananalangin. Praise God. Holy One of Israel, thank you so much, Lord, of your blessings. Bless the listeners today. Praise God. Touch their heart. Give us the strength spiritually to do good works. Hallelujah. That we may become a pattern for good works. That we can maintain good works. Not because we want salvation, but because you already saved us. Bless your church. Bless all our listeners, all my friends, colleagues in the ministry. Thank you so much, Lord. Thank you so much, Father. In Jesus' name, praise God. Hallelujah. Amen and amen. Thank you, Sister Ami Almatsa, for watching. Ana Victoria, Paye Ageri, Sister Sunya, Sister Belin, Sister Yuli from Discovery Bay, Marisa Vicente, Ma'am Jima Banyes, Sister Esther Olgasan in Butuan City. Thank you, thank you. Pastor Godfrey, thank you for watching. Melody, yes, Sister Bing, good works are not enough for salvation. You must repent, baptize in Jesus' name, and maintain good works. Glorify God. Kalupig Balanga, Albarico Alberto. Yes, there is one road I'll remember.
Thank you for watching Sir Rio, Juby Bartulay, Ibirin Galeasa, Bas Manalo, James Roque, Dennis Manipon, Earl John Bilunuak. Thank you for watching and listening. Thank you so much. Praise God to all our listeners again. Bertie Payawal, Mary Jean Duna Alijo, Bermal Joy Corpus, Virginia Balingaw, Victoria Sanchez, Escobal sa Discovery Bay, Elena Rodillas, Perez Cabanilla, Jerry Kumar sa Lagala. God bless. New Life Pearl. Taga saan ba ito si New Life Pearl? Praise God. Lidilin Osin. Oh, taga Kambuaksorne. God bless. Maraming salamat.